Don't touch that dial. Your PC hero coming up here in just a second.
From the Sunshine State, this is Tampa Bay's TAN Talk.
The annual Christmas episode is here, and we have some wishes for Santa, plus a list of the top tech gifts, and of course, the usual freebies, so stay tuned.
Rocketed from the dying planet Microsoft, raised by a kindly couple in the small town called Wasville, your PC hero grew strong knowing one day he would be the one to fight computer malware and ignorance. In his secret identity of mild-mannered tech reporter Alan Barebi, he fights for truth, justice, and the Jobsian way. And now, the one, the only, your PC hero.
Welcome, everyone, and Merry Christmas from your PC Hero coming to your rescue every single week. Don't forget to check out the website, yourpchero.com, where we post the links to everything that we discuss on each show, including the freebie choices. There's also a giant question mark on the right-hand side. Click on it. You can ask us any question. We answer every single one, but only one gets chosen to be on the show. And if you want to call in, the local number is 727-441-3000. Toll-free 866-826-1340. But before we get into all the Christmas goodies, let me introduce you to my bro, my partner in crime, the baddest man in technology, the shogun of technology, Mr. Andre.
Am I the meanest?
Sure, yeah.
Am I the prettiest?
Sure, yeah.
Am I the baddest mofo low down around this town?
Sure, yeah.
Well, who am I?
Sure, yeah.
Who am I?
Sure
enough! I can't hear you.
Sure enough!
And I want every woman out there to let Shoney Claus know what she wants for Christmas.
Oh, boy.
That's right. You let Shoney Claus. You come sit on Shoney Claus's lap and let's talk about Christmas, okay?
Oh, we're in trouble. Oh, boy. Oh, boy. All right. Well, speaking of Shoney Claus.
Shoney Claus. That's right, baby.
Should I be talking to you about what I want for my Christmas season or what?
No, not you. Only hot women.
All right.
That's the only people that I can help out is hot women.
Okay. Well, for those regular people.
That's right. The ordinary people that need to go to Santa.
That's right. I got some nice tech gifts that I'd like to talk about. Some of them I would personally love to have.
Okay.
Even though you know me, I probably have everything.
You already have everything because you spend your money on crap that nobody else would ever buy, but yes.
But you get the leftovers, so you can't complain.
And I do get the leftovers, so I won't complain.
Right. All right. Well, first of all, for myself, the things that are interesting me this holiday season, they come from the, there's a couple items. One is...
That nobody else would ever think of to buy or use.
Especially the second one,
I'm
sure.
Don't give these to your mother unless you want her to think you hate her.
Exactly, exactly. Well, the first one is a smartwatch. And I don't even know why I want it.
Yeah, why?
I don't even know which one I want.
Yeah.
But I feel like I have to delve into this technology a little bit.
You know what you need to do one day, bro? You need to take a picture of your office and put it up on the site.
Okay.
So everybody can see the colossal pile of crap you have accumulated over the years.
That's right.
All the stuff that you have bought that is still in the wrappers that you have absolutely no use for.
Unfortunately, that is very, very true.
It's very true.
Well, the smartwatch, like I said.
That's scary.
Have you seen the new smartwatch commercial with Samsung?
Have you seen this show, Hoarders?
No.
You have not?
No.
You should be on that show.
Tech Hoarders.
TechHoarders.com. That's right. The new website that we're going to set up with all of Alan's crap.
Okay. Beautiful. Well, anyway, have you seen the new Samsung smartwatch commercial?
Yes, I have.
Is that probably the worst commercial you've ever seen in your life?
It's almost as bad as the one for Target.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's almost as bad as the Target Christmas commercial.
Oh, my God. This smartwatch commercial was so horrific. I can't even imagine.
But you still want one, though.
Together.
But you still want to buy one.
No, actually, I want one that's not Samsung because of that commercial.
Really?
It annoyed me so much, I would not get a Galaxy Gear because of that commercial.
Just because of that commercial.
Just because of that commercial. Well, the second item that's on my wish list is really funky, really cool, and I'm probably about 20 to 30 years too old for it, but...
But you go on anyway.
Yes, it's the $294.50 basketball, okay? This basketball has sensors in it, so it helps coach you on all the things basketball-related, shooting, dribbling. It connects to an app. This is the craziest thing. It's a $300 basketball because of the sensors, but, yeah, it's supposed to make you a much better player. Where was this when I was 15?
I don't understand how that even works. I mean, if you're uncoordinated to begin with, people can coach you your whole life. And, you know, you'll still be the Happy Gilmore of basketball.
Well, what it basically does is that it examines the way you dribble, let's say. And it sees that you're weak, you know, your dribbling is weak. It'll tell you drills to do. And it'll watch how you're doing the drills. And it makes sure you're doing them right. Same thing with shooting.
See, that's cool. Because, I mean, I can dribble really good. Uh-huh. But I can't shoot a layup.
Right.
Bro, I tell you what, I look great when I'm putting that ball up in the air,
uh-huh.
But when it's like nowhere near even the backboard or the basket,
uh-huh.
It's really, really horrible to look at,
and
bro.
This thing is perfect for
and
you.
And you know me, I'm a Converse guy, man.
Uh-huh.
I mean, you know, I should be really good at basketball.
You should be.
But I'm horrible at it.
Okay.
I can dribble up. I can dribble and hand it off to somebody.
All right.
Yeah. I would love to see this work. I mean,
I would like to see it too. I'm hoping they're going to be at CES because I want to check it out.
Do they have videos?
They do have stuff on the website, which is on the link, shop.9450.com. Again, don't worry about writing it down. It'll be up on yourpchero.com at the end of the show.
Yeah, and for those of you who don't know what CES is, we are going to be at CES this year.
Mm-hmm.
So for those of you that are listening, it might potentially be there. Alan, you can tell them what CES is.
It's the Consumer Electronics Show. It's the big daddy tech show of the year. It's in Vegas. Every manufacturer of electronic devices, software, whatever. Vegas, baby.
Vegas, baby.
It's overwhelming. They show you the new phones, the new tablets, new TVs, new everything that you can possibly imagine. And we're very psyched. This is the show's first year there.
This is the show's first year, but the Shogun will be there in living color, baby.
That's right.
In living color.
All right. The last thing is I keep getting teased and tempted by the Surface 2, the Pro Edition. The Pro Edition. I don't know why. It keeps drawing me, but I keep pulling away and drawing me and pulling away.
It's Bill Gates' satanic pull on your life, bro.
I know.
Even though you'll never admit it, you've always been the Jobsian guy.
That's right.
You have to admit that there's a fascinating thing about Microsoft that you've never been able to get past.
At times.
At times.
I'll admit it. All right. Well, that's for me.
That's
okay?
Your kryptonite.
Right. And this is not necessarily gifts that I would recommend to people out there. I mean, I would not necessarily recommend a smartwatch yet because it's not a technology that is ready yet. The basketball, yeah, if you have a basketball lover in the family, maybe. But what I would recommend for other people, okay, the Kindle Fire HDX, which I'm going to review later on the show, okay, if you want a really good tablet but you don't want to spend the $400 plus that an iPad mini would cost, Kindle Fire is a good choice. And the Chromecast, I know you make fun of it, but it's getting more and more useful.
I didn't make fun of it. You made fun of it.
Well,
you told me how
it's getting better and better. It's getting better and better. $35. Can't beat it. All right. Show, baby. What are you going to tell Santa what you want this year?
Well, I've got a couple of different choices, Alan. You know that I'm a big fan of the Windows tablet. Been the biggest fan since it came out. I've been the biggest advocate for it. I'm seeing this really picking up steam in the enterprise market. I'm seeing businesses are going this direction.
Uh-huh.
I'm seeing that a lot of other companies are realizing, hey, this one device can do it all, baby.
Okay.
It makes the iPad look silly,
all right.
Honestly.
Okay.
So I've become a huge fan of convertible tablets now.
Really now?
I have. Because, you know, I've bought a few for a couple of people that are, you know, high-level people that can take this, they can put it in their docking station at work, they can do all their work. If they're doing a presentation, they can flip it over, they can do a presentation.
Mm-hmm.
If they're using it as a laptop on the road, they can use it as a laptop. And it does all this at an extremely competitive price.
All right.
Have you seen any of these yet?
I've seen a couple of them. I've seen the early Dell ones. I wasn't that impressed with it, but tell me the one that you like that you want from Santa.
Okay, so the one that I want is called the Lenovo IdeaPad.
All right.
And I know that people are not big fans of Lenovo.
I am, actually.
Are you really?
I do.
You're one of the few, because when I mention Lenovo to other people, they're like, I don't want it, you know, don't buy it for me, don't even recommend that.
Dell and Lenovo are the only ones I recommend.
But see, there's a lot of people that don't feel that way.
Okay.
They feel like IBM went that way.
They're crazy.
So there is right now, currently, a Lenovo IdeaPad. It's called the IdeaPad Yoga. Obviously, they call it yoga because it's so flexible like me.
Very flexible. Yes.
Just remember that, ladies.
Mm-hmm.
And this thing has a price point, believe it or not, under $400.
Nice.
right?
Nice.
It is an 11.6-inch screen.
Okay.
It converts from a laptop to a tablet seamlessly.
Right.
With very little effort. You don't have to be a technological genius to be able to do it.
Okay.
The only thing I don't like is it only comes with 2 gig of memory.
Which a lot of these tablets are doing that. So.
They do, but you can upgrade.
No, not in this one.
Oh, well, not in this one. Not but this you one. Can, right. you know, with a lot of the other ones.
Right.
And it's running Windows RT, which, you know, a lot of people have mixed reviews about RT. They really don't understand RT. You can't run Office. You can't do all these other things in there. Very big misnomer.
Mm-hmm.
And it is selling right now on Best Buy for $399.99.
Well, I'll tell you what I do like about it. I see that it's less than 3 pounds.
Yes.
That's might be my concern with these convertible tablets is that, you know, it's too heavy to be a real tablet.
Right, and Alan has very flabby muscles, so that's it's very extremely difficult for him to pick up anything larger than a coffee container.
I live a life of leisure, you know what I mean?
Exactly. That's right. Yeah, he's on Lifestyles of the Rich and Not Famous.
Exactly.
Right.
All right, very cool. All right, so $399 for a convertible laptop tablet. And I'm like you. I don't hate RT because I don't really use the full-blown Office for much anymore.
But
everything
Bert,
I'm doing is internet related.
You've got to admit that these are beginning to take off and beginning to get a huge amount of market share.
I agree.
I mean, honestly, everybody's starting to buy these.
I agree.
You know, and I wouldn't be shocked if Apple didn't come out with something like this very soon the road.
What's your second thing that you love so much?
The second thing I love is right along your lines, bro.
Oh, boy.
But you said nobody's perfected this, but LG has perfected this.
Okay.
LG has basically, it's a cell phone. It's a wrist, you know, phone-based cell phone.
Okay.
It's 13 inches.
Okay. No, 1.3
inches. I'm sorry. 1.3, I wish it was 13 inches.
I'm like, 13 inches on your wrist? Yeah. That would be horrible.
Yeah, it would be. I'm sorry, 1.3 inches. It's full touch screen.
Yeah.
It's 3G connectivity on a watch.
Okay.
Okay? Video call capabilities, Bluetooth V2.1. MP3 player built in.
Okay.
And it has voice recognition software.
All right.
Okay. It looks really slick.
Okay.
I watched the video on it. It's got some incredible features. You can make it look like a regular analog watch, old-fashioned watch, anything you want to do with it.
Okay.
Built-in calculator. The phone features are great. Touchscreen on it's great.
Uh-huh.
Very affordable. Very low price point. And mostly all of the major carriers are already starting to pick this phone up. Locally here in the United States.
All right. And now, of course, this is specific to the Shogun baby. So for other people, what kind of items you think are really cool buys that you would recommend?
Everything that I like. Everybody else is going to like. Because I'm the Shogun baby.
That's right.
But, you know, I mean, for the price point, you know, if you're buying stuff for other people, I'm going to tell you something that I saw the other day because I'm a big fan. Have you ever gotten the Hammacher Schemmler catalog?
Or you've been to New York? New York. I used to go
to
the store all the time.
You used to go to the store all the time.
Yeah.
So what they've got right now is they have a tablet, right? And I've seen this because I checked it out. It's a tablet that does 3D without the glasses on.
Okay.
And I have watched the video. I've experienced this. And it's incredible, dude. It's like being in IMAX, watching a movie in IMAX with the glasses on, without the glasses. And the quality is incredible. The price point to me for what it does is reasonable because it's under $400. It's actually under $350.
All right.
But if I was going to buy a present for somebody that I really cared about, which, you know, there's not
Kate Upton?
For Kate Upton, yes.
Yes, okay.
And there's very few other people that I really care about.
Really just her, basically.
Yeah,
okay.
Mostly everybody gets
and
you know,
Sukiyaki.
And Sukiyaki Sue.
Yeah.
Everybody else gets a gift card that's probably around about maybe $5-6 tops.
So this one, you would go to give it to Kate Upton.
I would give it to Kate Upton and Sukiyaki Sue. And I might buy you one, bro, because you are a friend.
Okay.
You know, but I have to think very hard about it and see if they had a refurb.
All right. Beautiful.
Yes.
And then you have another one. You have another gift item for other people.
Right. So my other one, again, is, you know, in the realm of tablets.
Okay.
It's a Windows-based tablet. It's not expensive. Really good price point.
For a Windows tablet, that is very cheap.
Yes. And it's not only is it a Windows tablet, bro, 32 gig of storage.
All right.
32 gig of storage, which you know, I mean, you couldn't even begin to break the top of an iPad
right.
for that much money.
Which model is this?
This is the Mix. I think it's a 2.8.
Yeah.
Right? Mix 2.8, 32 gigabit silver.
Lenovo Mix, yep.
Yep, made by Lenovo, another company who, again, like I said, people are very questionable about, but mm-hmm. I've been very impressed with their products. This thing is $299.99, less than $300 for the price point. Comes with free shipping, full version of Windows Pro on there.
Office, Home, and Student.
Office, Home, and Student, pre-installed, great warranty.
That's crazy.
Yeah, I'm telling you. I mean, now look at this, bro. You can watch movies on this thing.
Uh-huh.
It's an 8.5 touchscreen,
mm-hmm.
right? Which is not bad at all.
Not bad.
Slightly smaller.
Uh-huh.
Windows 8.1, not just Windows 8, Windows 8, but Windows
right.
8.1.
No, that
quad-core processor, bro.
Yeah,
Four cores in this baby.
Oh, I may have to change my mind about the Surface 2 and get one of these puppies.
This thing is bad. It's got an 8-megapixel camera.
Nice.
Digital camera. Bluetooth built in.
Okay.
Built in Wi-Fi.
Uh-huh.
Micro USB 2.0, so you can literally hook your printer up to this thing.
Beautiful.
Directly and do anything that you want. Intel product, great buy, great value. Lenovo stands behind it. It's less than $300. Probably find it cheaper than it is on Best Buy. Look in other places, but mm-hmm. this is the Shogun's pick.
I like it.
And
I like
it got great reviews.
I like it. I like it a lot. In fact, you may have twisted my brain in going this direction instead of a Surface. Windows 8 and Office,
yeah.
I mean,
yeah.
on the 300?
For under $300. I mean, the license alone costs that much.
That's what I'm saying. That's absolutely crazy.
Yes.
Very, very cool. And
so
again,
Microsoft's either desperate
right,
or they're starting to realize, hey, you know what? We can make some money selling superior tablets for less money.
Well, this is, again, by our buddies at Lenovo. The only two manufacturers I like are Lenovo and Dell. Again, don't worry about it if you're driving home. I know it's the rush hour about writing down these links or these names of these products. We're going to put everything up on the website, yourpchero.com. All right, when we come back from our break, we have some wishes for Santa for some of the big tech companies out there. So stay tuned.
I'm dreaming of a white Christmas, just like the ones I used to know.
I used to hate getting cuts because the stinky stuff mom used hurt worse than the cut. But now my mom uses Caricure Skin Protectant and it doesn't sting at all. Mom says that's because it's a water-based liquid bandage and doesn't have any chemicals. I can even swim in the pool and it doesn't come off. I've seen Dad use it on his running blisters and when he cuts himself shaving. He says he likes that it stops bleeding when he cuts himself. You should tell your mom to get Caricure. It's in the first aid aisle at Kroger. Caricure, healing the way nature intended.
All right, people, you love the show, and now you want to help, and you want to make some money, too. You can come to Your PC Heroes Rescue. We are hiring. That's right. We are looking for a salesperson. Part-time hours, full-time income, you cannot beat it. What do you think, show?
You can't make money any easier than this. I mean, this is like shooting ducks in a barrel here. All you got to do is come on here, get your dulcet tones on the phone, make a couple of phone calls from us, and the next thing you know, you're going to be rolling in barrels of money.
So if you want to apply for a job here with Your PC Hero, all you got to do is go to the website, hit the contact us button, and let us take care of the rest. YourPCHero.com, come to our rescue.
Is your computer running slower every day? Tried those speed up your PC scams you saw on TV? Do you just need help but don't know who to call or to trust? Well, Your PC Hero is here to come to your rescue. Contact Your PC Hero by calling 813-793-7462 or emailing us at help@yourpchero.com. That's 813-793-7462 or email at help@yourpchero.com. Your PC Hero to the rescue.
This is Your PC Hero, and everyone who listens to my show knows how much I love the little guy, the cool tech startup, the people who are doing fun things on the internet, even offline businesses that are using the internet to promote their stuff. Well, if you have a business or a cool story that you want to talk about on my show, then give me a call at 813 813- 813-444-3761. That's 813-44-HERO-1. And you too can be on Your PC Hero. How exciting is that?
No more excuses. Get your business online and let Your PC Hero come to your rescue with your domain, hosting, and traffic building needs. Your trusted name on the radio is also your only choice for domain registration, website and email hosting, and tools to generate online traffic. Go to yourpchero.biz for more information. That's yourpchero.biz to the rescue of your biz.
Does your business need a website and professional level email, but you do not have the budget for it, or you think you don't? Well, I have the solution for you. KRBWeb.com. That's right, KRBWeb.com. For as low as $6 a month, that's right, $6 a month, you can get website hosting, email with your domain, a free domain name, and it has a built-in website builder, so you don't even need a web designer. So get started, get your business on the internet at KRBWeb.com.
Have a question? Call in. Our numbers are 727-441-3000 or toll free 866-826-1340. That's 727-441-3000 or toll free 866-826-1340.
And we are back. Your PC Hero coming to your rescue with the Shogun of Technology sitting on my side
my
right
sake
here.
Saki wine.
And Suki Saki, baby.
Oh, baby, she's hot like Saki wine. That's what I want in my stocking this year.
All right. You hear that? Anybody who knows her, bring
That's
her
right.
over to the Shogun, baby.
That's right.
All right. Well, the first half of the show, we talked about all the toys and tech gifts for us and for other people and had our recommendations. Shogun had a really nice one with this Windows tablet that I am going to be really seriously looking into. And now, we're going to be a little bit unselfish and have our wishes for the biggest tech companies out there, what we hope to see from them in the near future. All right. Have you thought about this?
I've thought a lot about it, bro.
All right. Well, the first one is, and I want to say a frenemy, because while I hate what they're doing, I still use them a lot, and that is Facebook, baby. Facebook.
Yeah.
What would you like to see from them?
I like
hope
to see
Santa
them,
delivers.
I'd like to see them go away.
Really?
I'd like to see Santa have them just disappear off of the face of the earth. That's what I would like to see.
All right.
I'd like to see Zuckerberg in front of a firing squad for incompetence.
Now, tell me why you have these feelings about Facebook.
Bro, we did a Facebook show last week with your very lovely daughter, Caitlin. Uh-huh. And we talked about a lot of the things that Facebook is doing wrong.
Right.
And one of the things that I think Facebook is doing is they are alienating their core base of customers that they had at the very beginning when we were supporting them, when we were pouring, you know, droves of money and all of our time, a lot of valuable time into Facebook. And the things that we wanted from Facebook, we never expected that they would ever stab us in the back and become a mainstream company like MySpace. And they did exactly that.
Yeah.
They did exactly that. So my wish for next year is that Facebook gets destroyed by somebody like Instagram, which they can't because, you know.
They own it.
They own it. Exactly.
Right.
But they run out of money to buy people, you know, and Zuckerberg really gets serious and starts going back to what made Facebook the likable thing that it was in the past.
All right, well, I'm going to be a little bit more in the spirit of the season. And this is what I wish from Facebook. I wish that they would stop focusing on twisting ways to add the revenue and just focus on what the actual people using it want.
But
and the
never
first
do
thing
that.
Is fix that mobile app of theirs. It is still a horrific mobile app. It's always slow. It's always crashing. Stop worrying about how to squeeze in an ad here and there. The revenue will come. Okay, you're making billions of dollars already. Just start thinking about it. When you're adding a feature, say, does this benefit us or does this benefit the actual users?
But, bro, you know they don't care.
I know. This is a wish.
It's a wish.
Okay.
But you know what? As long as they're driven by ad revenue, they're never going to focus on a mobile app. They can care less. And I'm going to tell you why. Because they know that their period of time when they're going to actually be relevant is irrelevant.
It's debatable, but yeah, I think it could
They're
be very.
Go away.
It could be. It could. It could
what
be
happened
serious
to MySpace,
trouble.
Bro?
Yeah, yeah. It could happen.
Where are they?
It happened. I mean, the kids are leaving, which is a bad sign.
Yeah.
When the kids leave, you're in trouble.
What happened to MySpace?
All right, now we're gonna talk about one of your buddies, Google. Okay. What do you want to see from Google this year? What do you wish Santa will bring you from Google this year?
What do I want to see from Google, bro? I want to see complete world domination.
Okay.
I want to see them owning everything, looking at everything. I want, if you go to the doctor for a colon exam, that Google is there with one of their sets of eyeglasses, bro, looking up your rectum. That's what I want.
All right.
Because that's what they're doing.
Yes.
Right?
But you're okay with them dominating, but you're not okay with Facebook dominating.
No, I'm not, bro. This is pure sarcasm here, okay?
All right. What do
you
want?
What I would love to see is I would love to see Google back off.
Uh-huh.
All of those old things, you know, the island of broken toys.
Mm-hmm.
I would love to see Google bring back some of those things that they bought, that they just basically retired.
That's interesting.
Bring those back, bro. Some of those things were stuff that we really, really liked and wanted to keep alive.
Uh-huh.
You own it now. You don't have to be, you know,
greedy
about it anymore. It's yours. Nobody else has come back and tried to do it. Mm-hmm. You own the copyright. You own the trademarks.
Mm-hmm.
Bring it back now.
That's very, very interesting. In fact, if Google doesn't want to bring it back, how about releasing it to the open source community so other people can take care of it?
No, because then it's a threat.
Right.
They're not going to ever do that.
Well, what I would like to see from Google is a little more clarity on the privacy issue. And believe it or not, improvement in their products, because I believe that their search has gotten worse. Their picture search, image search, has gotten abysmal.
Oh, yeah, it's
horrible. I mean, I could put things in quotes or not in quotes, and there's no change.
No, it's horrible. And the flash element of that thing where it brings up that focus page, that's just horrific.
Absolutely horrible. So believe it or not, I want improvements from Google and more clarity on your overall, since they want to own your identity on the internet, your overall identity, what can and cannot be allowed. That's what I would like to see. All right. We go from Google, the big monster, to the darling of the internet world, and mainly because of Marissa Mayer, and that is Yahoo. Yahoo! So, any wishes? I mean, do you even use Yahoo?
No.
No?
No.
No.
I do look at Marissa
Mayer
every once in a while, though. And my Christmas wish is to see her in an elf hat with a bikini on.
Okay, there you go.
That's
Shogun
it. That's
wishes from
it.
Yahoo.
I have very little, you know, I don't ask a lot.
No.
I don't ask a lot.
All right. What I would like to see from Yahoo is less smoke and more substance.
They have no substance. They never have.
Yeah. And the first thing they got to do is they got to fix, I know they've tried, one of the worst email, you know, free email systems is Yahoo's.
Bro, it's horrible.
It's right up there with AOL. And Hotmail?
You know, once a year.
But Hotmail got better with Outlook.com. They got a lot better.
You know, once a year at Christmas time, I do two things.
Okay.
I try a fruitcake.
Okay.
Just to see if it's ever gotten any better, if they've started to see if they've started adding bourbon to it. You know, because then I might even entertain it.
Yeah.
And then the second thing is I open a new Yahoo account. Every year I do it like clockwork, bro. Just before the new year.
Right.
I get a new Yahoo email account, and then I try to set Yahoo as my homepage, and I try to see how long I can live with it.
It's hard.
It's extremely difficult, bro. I can't go an hour.
I
even tried to get Mrs. Nuff to do it, and she wouldn't do it.
And which one? Mrs. Nuff 1, 2, or 3?
The ones that you don't know about.
Okay.
Trust me.
Yeah, I have a big problem with it. They continue to have really poor spam filtering on there.
Yeah.
And that's one thing I'll say about Gmail. Spam filtering is beyond reproach. It's unbelievable.
And it just makes, you know, but the one thing I have to say about Gmail is it makes sense.
Yeah.
You know, the mail piece of it makes sense.
I know.
With Yahoo, it's just a huge disappointment.
Yeah. And if they want to go to this mobile environment, they got to fix it and fix it quickly.
Yeah.
All right. We got a couple of minutes left before the break. We got your buddies at Microsoft. What is the number one thing that you wish Santa would bring you from Microsoft in the next, you know, year or so?
Well, like I've told you, my focus on Microsoft right now is mobility.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they're doing a great job with their cloud offering. My number one thing that I want from Microsoft is I want a cloud-based operating system.
Okay.
That'll run on anything. That's
right.
What I want. I want to run Office. I want to run all my enterprise-level apps, SQL, all that stuff, and I want to run it from the cloud.
Okay.
That's it.
All right. My wish is a little bit different, and that is I want them to stop trying to make the desktop Windows this hybrid environment and just admit your mistake and make Windows 8.2 or whatever a full-blown desktop environment with something that's sorely missing, more connectivity to your mobile devices. For example, in my dream world, you log into your Windows 8 account on your desktop, and once you log in on your tablet, you don't have to do anything to remote desktop in. Okay? You don't have to do anything to see your, you know, your SkyDrive file. Everything is just automatically connected. You know what I mean?
Yep.
So that if I'm signed in on my tablet, I click remote desktop, boom, I can see my desktop.
But you know what? If they did a cloud-based OS, none of that would matter anymore.
Very, very true. But stop with the tiles and forcing it down our throat on the desktop. It works great on the mobile environment. I've always been a fan of it. I've always felt that the Windows mobile phone is underrated.
Yep.
The only thing that was missing and still missing is, which is beyond belief to me, how it doesn't sync with Outlook.
Yeah.
I mean, Apple's iPad sync with Outlook, but Windows mobile doesn't sync with Outlook.
And get some better music on your commercials, for God's sake.
Oh, yeah. And no more annoying commercials.
Yeah, they're so annoying. Stop. And the music is just horrific.
Right. Okay. And, you know, just focus on the business user.
Yeah.
All right, and then, of course, we come to the big boys, and that's Apple.
Apple.
Oh, boy. Oh, boy. Oh, boy.
Oh, yeah.
Jobs, we miss you. We miss you terribly. Apple has been boring for a very, 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 very long time. What would you like to see from Apple, my friend?
I would. You know what's happened with Apple, honestly, Alan? You remember, you know, Apple back in the early 80s?
Yeah.
When they first came out and they had all these products and you were like, you know, begging for them to give you a reason to move away from Microsoft. And they just couldn't come up with anything that really grounded you in saying, I want to be an Apple person. I don't want to ever look at Microsoft again. And it's like they evolved and they got to that point where everybody wanted Apple. Everybody wanted everything to be Mac related. You know, and now it's like they're gravitating back towards this mediocre product line that's kind of very similar to where they were in the 80s, you know, and it's like they've lost their vision. They can't really figure out how to get out of this.
That's because you got sales guys running the company now.
Yeah, you got sales guys and you got guys that really didn't sit at the campfire of, you know, Steve Jobs and kind of try to say, I want to be like this guy and understand what his direction is and where he's going to take the company for the next 10 years.
You know,
ten years down the road, it wouldn't have mattered.
You know, they have Jobs' boy, Johnny Ives, which is getting, you know, he's like the guy the tech guys love. Oh, he's a vision. He's not a visionary, okay? Johnny Ives is a designer, okay? He knows how to make beautiful products. There's no question about it. He makes beautiful phones, beautiful laptops, all that. But he's not the kind of guy who's going to come up with a new product that no one thought of, like when the iPod came or when the iPad came. That's going to blow people out of the water. And unfortunately, they can coast for a while on just making better iPhones, better iPads, blah, blah, blah. But the thrill is gone.
Yeah, I mean, you know, the iPhone 5, the sales, you know, went sky high for a little bit.
Right.
And then they just plummeted.
Yeah.
You know,
and
even the commercials.
Yeah,
and the commercials for the 5C have been horrible.
Yeah.
I mean, to say the least. And, I mean, there's nothing that entices me to buy that phone.
Right.
You know, I mean, hearing, you know, some musician that, you know, maybe kids like or whatever, doesn't really tell me anything about why I should buy that phone.
Right.
You know, just because it's multiple colors?
Yeah.
I mean, please.
Yeah. For those of you out there, I want you to turn to your wife or someone, I don't want to be sexist, or turn to your husband who's not really a tech person and tell him, hey, do you want the new iPhone 5S because it has a 64-bit processor in it? And you tell me if that means anything to most people.
No, and I mean, as a matter of fact, ask them if they want one, why they want one. I guarantee they can't tell you why. They'll just tell you it's because it's the iPhone.
Right.
That's the only reason they can give you anymore. It's just become a status symbol with no, you know, nothing really that anybody would really think about and say, I want this phone because it does this or it does that.
Here's what I would like to see from Apple. I would like to see one brand new product that either no one thought about or has a feature that no one ever imagined, but once they hear it, they got to have it. And also, improve Siri.
You know, it's really funny. I was reading an article about, you know, what Apple was talking about for next year, about their product shakeups for next year. And this is the first time in an article where I've ever heard them in years mention having to compete against Microsoft for any type of space at all.
Mm-hmm.
But Microsoft literally has them so scared with the, you know, with the convertible tablets and everything else, and getting starting to get market share on that, mm-hmm. that they're really scared that by next year they're not going to be able to keep up anymore. Yeah. And it's very, very true, because there's nothing appealing about another iPad.
Right.
Nothing at all.
And I agree with you. And so we need some kind of innovation from Apple, because it's getting old, guys. And the more it's business as usual, the less, you know, cool it becomes. And Apple was built on being cool.
Yeah.
Now, speaking of cool, all right, there's one company that we didn't mention, and that was Amazon. All right?
Yeah.
And Bezos is the closest thing we have to Jobs right now. I know some people think the guy who runs Tesla, Elon Musk, is the guy, but I still say Bezos is really the next heir to the throne.
Yeah.
And I want to hear your thoughts about what Amazon should do in the next few years. But I'll tell you, I got the Kindle Fire, the 7-inch HDX. It was a $50 off sale, so it was $179.
Right.
And I had the original Kindle Fire. There's no comparison. First of all, it blows it out of the way. It's fast. It's smooth. The screen is beautiful. I mean, if you want an inexpensive 7-inch tablet that can play your movies and go on the internet, and I mean, the only weakness to this is still the same weakness on all of the Kindles, is I'm not crazy about the OS, you know, and there's a lack of good apps.
Yeah.
You know, but for content consumption, it's a great, great tablet.
But you have to remember, Bezos has a great vision.
Yeah.
You know?
Uh-huh.
He wants to become the guy that sells everything
right
to everybody.
Right.
So, you know, I mean, even with the Kindle right now,
mm-hmm.
you know, I mean, you got to figure it's in its somewhat of its infancy.
Mm-hmm.
It's only evolved through 3 revisions so far. And the new tablet's incredible. You know, I mean, you have to admit, it's really, really nice for what it does.
Uh-huh.
The apps will come later on.
Hopefully.
But right now, Amazon's focusing on their vision, which is to be the master. They want to be the Walmart of the internet, bro. They're going to be the Walmart of the internet.
And he has flat out said he doesn't care if you buy a new one.
Nah.
If you have an old Kindle, he's happy. He wants you to buy the content. That's why he doesn't make anything on those
devices.
Yeah,
he doesn't. And somehow they're still figuring out a way to make money. I still haven't figured out Amazon Prime. Have not figured out how that makes money for them.
I know, with the free video and the free shipping and everything else.
I have not figured out. And I'm a big fan. I signed up for it a couple of months ago.
Mm-hmm.
And I've used it consistently. I did all my Christmas shipping on Amazon. Uh-huh. Didn't pay a dime in shipping costs at all, and I did all of my shopping on there.
Well, I agree with you. I haven't figured it out, unless it's something where they're just going to drive every competitor out of the business. And
they're
then,
doing it.
Yeah.
It's happening.
But for those who don't know what Amazon Prime is, and that's not a bad gift, by the way.
No, it's a great
$79 a year, and you get a Netflix type of video streaming.
Right.
And free 2-day shipping if you do a lot of buying, and a bunch of other features too.
Right.
All right. When we come back from our break, we're going to do our pet peeves and our freebie choices of the week, so stay tuned.
Jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun.
I used to hate getting cuts because the stinky stuff Mom used hurt worse than the cut. But now my mom uses Caricure Skin Protectant, and it doesn't sting at all. Mom says that's because it's a water-based liquid bandage and doesn't have any chemicals. I can even swim in the pool and it doesn't come off. I've seen Dad use it on his running blisters and when he cuts himself shaving. He says he likes that it stops bleeding when he cuts himself. You should tell your mom to get Caricure. It's in the first aid aisle at Kroger. Caricure, healing the way nature intended.
All right, people, you love the show and now you want to help and you want to make some money too. You can come to your PC Heroes Rescue. We are hiring, that's right. We are looking for a salesperson. Part-time hours, full-time income, you cannot beat it. What do you think, show?
You can't make money any easier than this. I mean, this is like shooting ducks in a barrel here. All you got to do is come on here, get your dulcet tones on the phone, make a couple of phone calls from us, and the next thing you know, you're going to be rolling in barrels of money.
So if you want to apply for a job here, with Your PC Hero. All you got to do is go to the website, hit the contact us button, and let us take care of the rest. YourPCHero.com. Come to our rescue.
Is your computer running slower every day? Try those speed up your PC scams you saw on TV? Do you just need help but don't know who to call or to trust? Well, Your PC Hero is here to come to your rescue. Contact Your PC Hero by calling 813-793-7462 or emailing us at help@yourpchero.com. That's 813-793-7462 or email at help@yourpchero.com. Your PC Hero to the rescue.
This is Your PC Hero, and everyone who listens to my show knows how much I love the little guy, the cool tech startup, the people who are doing fun things on the internet, even offline businesses that are using the internet to promote their stuff. Well, if you have a business or a cool story that you want to talk about on my show, then give me a call at 813-444-3761. That's 813-44-HERO-1, and you too can be on Your PC Hero. How exciting is that?
No more excuses. Get your business online and let Your PC Hero come to your rescue with your domain, hosting, and traffic building needs. Your trusted name on the radio is also your only choice for domain registration, website and email hosting, and tools to generate online traffic. Go to yourpchero.biz for more information. That's yourpchero.biz to the rescue of your biz.
Does your business need a website and professional level email, but you do not have the budget for it, or you think you don't? Well, I have the solution for you. KRBWeb.com. That's right, KRBWeb.com. For as low as $6 a month, that's right, $6 a month, you can get website hosting, email with your domain, a free domain name, and it has a built-in website builder, so you don't even need a web designer. So get started, get your business on the internet at KRBWeb.com.
Have a question? Call in. Our numbers are 727-441-3000 or toll free 866-826-1340. That's 727-441-3000 or toll free 866-826-1340.
I have a lot of experience with the whole computer thing, you know, emails, sending emails, receiving emails, deleting emails, I could go on.
All righty. And speaking of emails, we told you in the beginning of the show that if you go to yourpchero.com, there's a giant question mark on the right-hand side. You click on it, you can ask us any question, tech-related or even love-related, and the Shogun will answer those.
That's right.
But only one gets chosen to be on the show every week, and this is from Robert from Brandon. Does Carbonite back up my USB drive? And the answer is no.
Does not. Nope.
First of all, I've spoken about this before, and I know with laptops, you have limited space, so it's tempting to put all your important stuff on a backup drive. The problem is, if that goes, you're done.
Yeah. I mean, I routinely leave my USB drives in my pocket, and they go through the wash.
Right.
Always. Well, so I don't put anything important on
there. And even if you buy a big one that's plugged into the wall and everything, you're going to lose your data because drives fail all the time, and it's only in one location. So I never recommend having your most important information on a USB drive.
No, and
have it on the
laptop,
and then back. It's for backups.
And that's not what USB drives are made for.
However, honestly, if you can't avoid it, and I don't know why, but if you can't avoid it and you need an online backup that will back up your USB drive, the only one that I've seen that does that is Backblaze, which is neck and neck with Carbonite as my favorite online backups. Yeah. It does the same thing, unlimited. And actually, when you have a USB drive connected to it, you can select that and tell Backblaze to back that up as well. So, Robert, Backblaze is the answer for you. All righty. Our pet peeves of the week. Shogun, baby. I like yours.
Bro, you run across this all the time.
Oh, yeah.
You've said this a million times.
Mm-hmm.
The one thing I can't stand, you know, I went home the other day, and I've got a printer that's, you know, back from the days when, you know, printers were printers like men were men.
You mean it has a crank on the back?
It has a crank on the back. It's got the built-in fax modem, fax machine, only scans in black and white. It's as big as my couch.
Okay.
You know, and I've got it in the back room there, and when it kicks on, it sounds like a fighter jet firing up.
Beautiful.
Yeah, and it's a great printer. I mean, it works. It does what it needs to do. I plugged in a computer that you had set up for me the other day, which was Windows 7.
Uh-huh.
You know, okay, so Windows 7 you expected. This was a common printer name, brother.
Right.
you know?
Uh-huh.
Could not find the drivers for the life of it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, came back with some generic driver that didn't work, mm-hmm. spit out five reams of paper before I could quit the print job. Had to go on the website, look for the printer driver there.
Uh-huh.
Nothing compatible to Windows 7. Now, Windows 7's been out for a while now.
Right.
So, you know, it's either that my equipment's too old and I'm just not, you know, evolving and buying new stuff, or it's just that Windows is still doing a horrible job with drivers.
Yeah.
Why can't there be a universal standard for a printer? If you buy a printer, why can't there be one driver that works for every printer?
I've always wanted the same thing.
Yeah.
I've always wanted the same
thing. I mean,
they've
got all these universal languages for everything else. Why can't we have one
we
for
have it
printers?
For mice. We have it for keyboards.
Yeah.
You don't have to download drivers for those things.
No. One driver and it does it all.
All right. I'm with you. And that really annoys me, too. Now, I don't know when the last time you set up a Windows 8 machine.
The other day.
Okay. Did you get to the point where you have to put in a Hotmail account or a Live account to get past it?
I did, and here's what happened. I put in a, you know, you can skip that, and you can put in a regular
account. But they're making
it
harder and harder to see where to skip it.
Yeah, and let me tell you something. I skipped it, and then I went on the App Store to go get an app that I wanted.
And they wanted the account.
And I had to set up the account, and it immediately reverted my account back to the regular account.
Yeah.
The worst problem that I have is that the Hotmail account that they have on record for me puts up the wrong name. Somebody hacked Yahoo's accounts a long time ago when you used your Hotmail account. Mm-hmm. So now when I put it in, my computer says, welcome, Gabriella Saunders.
Right.
I am not Gabriella Saunders. I don't look like Gabriella Saunders. I've looked Gabriella Saunders up.
Uh-huh.
She's hot, even though she's a nasty hacker.
Right.
But she's still a hot chick. Unless she stole that picture from some Ukrainian model or something.
Well, I agree with you. I don't want to be forced to have an online account. I mean, Apple, when you set it up, you could skip it.
Yeah.
I know everything is going to this constantly connected world, but it has to be easier. Stop Microsoft. You've got a product that's getting better and better. Stop making it more difficult and more difficult. Make it very easy for me to just have a local account and not this Hotmail account. Because all you're going to do is make me open up a Hotmail account just for this and never use it for anything else. So stop it, okay?
But in defense of Microsoft, Apple does the same thing.
But
because
it's a little
easier.
Because
you don't have to log in on the computer, but if you want any apps or anything,
of course,
to have an Apple ID.
Even if it's free.
Even if it's free. You still got to log in. You still got to get it.
Drives me crazy. All right. Now we come to the, you know, the best part of the show, and that is the freebie choices of the week. This is every single week. The Shogun and I pick either a free program, a free app, a free website resource that provides a lot of value in these hard economic times. Not something that's free and is crippled. This is really good stuff. And we have a list of everything we've ever recommended on the website, yourpchero.com. Shogun, what is your freebie choice for this week?
My freebie choice for this week is a website called Fat Paint.
Okay.
You know, not fat like, you know, fat chicks, but fat paint, bro.
All
and
right.
Not fat like P-H-A-T, but F-A-T, fat.
Okay.
What I like about Fat Paint is it's a web-based design software.
All right.
For web design, for graphic designers.
Okay.
And it lets you, like, build logos, websites, software, all kinds of stuff. The cool thing that I like about it is that they also give you the ability to do something like Cafe Press.
Uh-huh.
Where you can take the stuff that you've made and you can put it on different things like cups, shirts, whatever, to fund your site or to fund your development or to fund anything that you're doing. So let's say, for example, you know, I make a logo for Shogun's Christmas Balls, which is going to be out next year.
Nice.
Right?
Okay.
The Shogun's Christmas Balls will sell on Fat Paint, right? And I can sell T-shirts with pictures of the Shogun's Christmas Balls on them.
That's nice.
Yeah, and make money.
I don't know about making money. Now, don't go crazy here. You'll be the only one buying it. And if you buy it, you don't make money.
No, trust me. Millions are going to buy these.
Uh-huh.
Yep.
Okay. Nice. All right. So, fatpaint.com. And again, remember, the links will be up on the website, yourpchero.com. Show, baby, you've heard me talk about Cloud Magic before.
Yes, you have.
This is an app. Right now, it's free. So, maybe a year from now, it won't be free. But while it's free,
not.
I have to recommend it. It is the original one was basically a search engine for all your online email.
Right.
And it was phenomenal. I mean, really, it was great. Well, now they figured out that How about we incorporate it into an actual email app? And they've come out with the Cloud Magic email that for now it's free. That is the same thing. It's an email app for your iPhone or Google Android, and it has the best search. Because the Apple search in the email app that comes with the iPhones is terrible. This one will go into the cloud, into all of your email accounts. Not only does it search for the email, like for example, if I say Shogun recommendation, it'll not only pull up all your emails, it'll pull up your name, your profile, anything related to the Shogun.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
It's amazing.
And the thing about it is, I'll tell you what the most amazing thing about this is.
Huh.
It is super fast.
Very fast.
I mean, it is so fast, I was completely shocked that it could scour the internet for that content and come back with a result literally in seconds.
Now, if you tell me, this is something that Google should be looking into buying.
And they will. They'll buy it, and then they'll retire.
And then they'll retire.
Yeah, they'll send it to the land of broken toys.
Yeah, it is amazing. I love it. One of the best email-related apps that I've seen in a long time, cloudmagic.com. And again, remember, the links will be up on the website, yourpchero.com, so check it out.
Yeah, they'll find a way to monetize it by next year.
Oh, boy. Thanks for ruining my Christmas.
Yes, absolutely. That's why I live.
And it works, by the way, with all your favorite online email services, Office 365, Google email, Yahoo's email, Microsoft's email, IMAP, everything you can possibly imagine, it works with it.
Yeah, it's great. I mean, I've used it. I've used it a couple of times with different things, and it is great. It also works, did you mention Office?
Yeah.
Okay,
Office 365 and their emails, too.
Yep, so it goes through everything.
All righty. Well, Shogun, baby, Merry Christmas, first of all.
Merry Christmas to you, my brother.
It's been more than a year now.
And it has been, man. We've been out here. Can you believe that?
I know.
We've done a lot of shows, bro, and given out a lot of really good information to people.
That's it.
And it's evolved. It's changed. You know, we've had staff changes. We've had people that have been here. And
time
we've had
changes.
Great time changes. Great interviews.
Right.
Not so great interviews.
Uh-huh.
You know, and now we're going into a new year, bro, 2014.
Right. And CES in a few weeks.
I think it's the year of the rat this year.
You think
I think so. I could be wrong.
Okay.
You know, it's the year of something.
Right. Well, I personally would like to wish all our readers and our online listeners and our live listeners a very, very Merry Christmas.
And Kwanzaa.
And Kwanzaa.
And Hanukkah.
And a delayed... Right.
Right.
Happy Hanukkah.
Yep. And the Chinese New Year, whatever that is.
And whatever else you can come up with.
Right.
Happy holidays. I want to wish happy holidays to you and your family, Show Baby.
That's right. The ones that, my 500,000 children.
That's right.
Right.
And
Don't worry, kids. The child support checks are on the way. Mail is slowed down for the holidays, but they will be there.
I want to also wish a Merry Christmas to Kate Upton for not filing that restraining order against the Shogun
here. Yes, as always, I could not be here, and I thank you, Kate. Send me your new number, please,
right.
And your new email address. I have your address already.
And even though this is not Thanksgiving, I'm very thankful, Show, for being here with me.
I
appreciate it, and I'm thankful to the wife, Karen, my two kids, Kaylin and Haley, and all my family and my friends, and... It's been a wonderful ride so far, and I hope it continues.
That's right, man. I'm happy for all of those people that are my friends and family who shall remain anonymous, you know? And I hope, you know, I mean, next year's going to be a great year, bro.
It is.
I feel it, you know? And when we come back from CES, we're going to have a show that's going to knock the socks off of these folks.
Not Shogun Show, an actual show.
Well, the Shogun will be here, you know?
That's right.
And like I said, start putting in your orders for the show Christmas Balls early this next year.
Oh, boy.
Because they're going to sell out. I guarantee you, before next January, they'll be sold out, you know. And I know you want Santa to put a set in your stocking.
Right, right.
Right?
Oh, boy. Okay, on that note, I'm going to tell you guys that next week will be our year in review. Everything that happened in 2013, the biggest stories, we're going to go over it. Merry Christmas from our family, your PC Hero, to you guys. We're out.